हेलो डियर लर्नर्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अखिलेश सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड प्रोग्राम कोऑर्डिनेटर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ टूरिज्म, उत्तराखंड ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ट्रैवल डिट्रेंट्स. अर्लियर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ट्रैवल मोटिवेशनल फैक्टर्स और डिफरेंट पर्पजेज ऑफ ट्रैवल. ट्रैवल मोटिवेशनल फैक्टर्स आर द फैक्टर्स विच एनकरेज ए पर्सन टू ट्रैवल टू एनी डेस्टिनेशन. दीज मोटिवेट्स ए पर्सन एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दीज मोटिवेशनल फैक्टर्स ए पर्सन इज मोटिवेटेड और get interested to travel to any destination in order to enjoy any particular activity or event. Now we will discuss about travel deterrents. Travel deterrents are the factors which discourage a person, which demotivates a person and person not get interested to travel to the destination. Here I have mentioned 14 different travel deterrents which always discourage a person or group of tourists to not to travel to the important tourist destinations. The first important travel deterrent is high cost of the tour. As we know that tour package includes so many components, and all these components include high money. And because of this reason, low income class people or lower middle income class people never get interested to travel to the destination, because it is not possible to travel to the destination in this low budget. And we also see that low income class people and lower middle income class people never travel to the destination. Hardly will find any person or family, those who travel to the destination once in a year. Now the second important point is non-availability of leisure time. As we know that leisure time is the time in which a person can do recreational activities. In leisure time, we can only do such kind of activities. But a person, those who have not leisure time, cannot travel to the destination. We can take the examples of politicians, businessmen, or our celebrities. They don't have leisure time. And because of this reason, they rarely travel to the destination. So to travel to a particular attraction or destination, leisure time should be available to the person. Third important point is poor health. As we know that health is the important factor because of which a person leads a good life. And because of poor health, not only he suffers, but his family members also suffers a lot. And because of this reason, sometimes a person or even his entire family members cannot travel to the destination. We can take the example of any disabled person who not only suffers by himself, but also his family members suffers a lot. And because of this reason, they rarely or they never plan to travel to the destination. So good health of the family members is necessary to make plans to travel to the destination. We can also take the example of senior citizens. Those who have senior citizens in their family member, they also avoid to travel to the destination because they have to take care of their elders. Fourth important point is family size. We know that in nuclear families, those parents who have only one or two kids, they travel to the destination once in a year. But on the other hand side, the family which have a large number of family members, for example, if a couple has more than three or four children, then you will find that they rarely plan a tour package. And you will rarely find that they travel to the particular destination. They always avoid because they know that it is hard to travel to the destination and take care of all their children. When we find a low number of family members, then we see that they always plan to travel to the destination. Now, fifth point, lack of interest and awareness. Sometimes we see that any person don't have any interest or he is not aware about the importance to travel to the destination. And because of this reason, a person or entire family members never travel to the destination. Because if a person is interested to the travel destination, then he must aware about the importance and the benefits of traveling to the destination. We find that many parents travel to the destination along with their children because they want to show the different destinations. They want to tell the historical features of the destination to their children. And because of this reason, they travel to the destination. And because many people know that when they will travel, then they can get strong memories in their mind. And because they know that by reading only, they cannot get good knowledge or the importance of the destination. Then sixth point is terrorism activities. As we know that many countries of the world are suffering from terrorism activities, and because of this reason, they always lack the inflow of good number of tourists in their country. We can take the example of Afghanistan and Syria. These are the countries which suffered a lot from terrorism activities, and because of this reason, tourists always avoid to travel to these countries. As we know that India, Jammu and Kashmir state is also suffering a lot from terrorism activities, and because of this reason, this destination, which has a large number of scenic beauty, but it always lacks the inflow of good number of domestic as well as international tourists. Seventh point is poor services provided by hotels. As we know that in urban areas or in metropolitan cities, we find every category of accommodation where we find good quality of service provided by the hotel staff. But in some cities which are not very popular, or some small cities, or some outer part of the cities, or the cities which are not very important in terms of tourism, there we find very low quality or cheap kind of services provided by the hotel staff. And because of this reason, many tourists avoid to travel to the destination because they know that they will not get good accommodation, good fooding at the hotel. Then eighth point is very high transportation fee. Sometimes, as we know that when a person is interested to travel to any European country or American continent, then he will have to use the services of airlines. And if he will use airline services, then he will have to pay a large amount of money. And because of this reason, low income class people always avoid to travel to the destination because it is not comes in their budget. If a person gets ticket price in his budget, then he always plans to the travel to the destination. We can take India's example. Many North Indian tourists want to travel to the South India, but they don't have leisure time. So they always want to travel to South India by using airlines. And because of this reason, they have to pay a lot. And because of this reason, many low-income class people avoid to travel to South India. Ninth point, non-availability of desired food. Sometimes we see that many tourists who like vegetarian foods, and they find only non-vegetarian items at the destination. And because of this reason, such vegetarian people avoid to travel to the destination. And sometimes we also see that any non-vegetarian, when he travels to any such kind of destination where he don't find non-vegetarian items in any restaurant or hotel, then he also avoids to travel to the destination. Sometimes North Indians, when they travel to South India, they rarely find in North India's cuisines. They don't find chapati, rice, dal, sabji, etc. In South India, you find dosa, idli, and other kind of South Indian cuisines. And because of this reason, many tourists avoid to travel to such destinations where they don't find their desired food. Then poor relationship between two countries. As we know that when there is a poor relationship between two countries, then governments suggest to their citizens to not to travel to any destination. We can take the example of India and Pakistan relationship. As we know that India's relationship with Pakistan is not good. And because of this reason, many times both countries' government suggest to their citizens to not to travel to the destination. And because of this reason, people always avoid to travel to these kind of countries. We can take another example. India's relationship is also not good with China. And because of this reason, people avoid to travel to China country. Then 11th point is rites. As we know that rites take place every part of the world, and because of this, not only local people suffers a lot, but tourists also suffers a lot. And the tourists who are staying in the hotel or who have reached at the destination, and because of rites, they sometimes become the victim of such kind of rites. And rites are temporary things which stops the movement of tourists, but these are the temporary incidents, and after some time the tourism again increases at the destination. Then the point is natural disasters. As we know that earthquakes, cyclones, floods and tsunami are the very common disasters which are created by nature, and human has no role in this, and human cannot control to these kind of activities. Human can only predict about the cyclone, floods and tsunami of the destination. We can take the example of tsunami which affected to South India. We can take the earthquake which affected Bhuj area of Gujarat state. And these kind of factors always affect the movement of tourists to the destination, but in a very short period of time. Then the last point is hijacking of civilian aircraft. As we know that in year 2001, when terrorists hijacked five different aircrafts of America and attacked on the Pentagon and World Trade Center of USA, and because of this reason, many people lost their lives, and it affected a lot to the tourism industry of not only USA, but tourism industry of entire world. We can take another example of India. As we know that in India, terrorists hijacked a plane, and because of this reason also, people avoided to travel to India. So these kind of activities always affects to the tourism movement to the destination, and government should try to understand these travel deterrents, and they should provide a good platform, good atmosphere at the destination, so that people can get interested to travel to the destination. So dear students, here we had discussed about travel deterrents. In our next video, we will understand about any other topic. Thank you so much.